protests and the controversy that prompted them strike a chord with the family of Jonathan Farrell. It brings back memories. He was shot and killed by a CMPD officer back in 2013. There was a mistrial in the case that prompted protests locally. The defender's Michelle Bowden covered that case, and she spoke with the family again today about what we're seeing now.
It happened just about 7 years ago, but as you can imagine, this is an open wound for the family. And his brother told me this morning they feel like not much has changed since they lost Jonathan, and they're glad to see the protests across the country.
Willie and Jonathan Farrell were just a year apart and as close as brothers can be.
We was extremely close. They showed our connection.
The younger brother now struggles every time he sees other people on TV who've lost loved ones at the hands of police officers.
It brings back a lot of memory. I think it more so brings the memories whenever I see the family members.
Jonathan Farrell had wrecked his car here in Charlotte around 2:30 in the morning back in 2013. He went for help, knocking on a woman's door. She mistook him for a robber and called 911. When police arrived, they said Farrell lunged at them. Police shot him 10 times, killing him. A jury deadlocked and the officer was set free. The city of Charlotte paid the Farrell family more than $2 million.
Shut it down!
And people in Charlotte protested for days.
I don't think my family got the justice that we wanted.
He says officers rarely get convicted or rarely held accountable, and that's why we're seeing nationwide protests.
I know that police violence will never end because it's something that's been going on forever.
Breathe for George! Breathe for
He's glad others are now raising their voices.
I think it's great. So many people are tired of seeing and hearing the same cases and seeing the same things. It just shows unity and shows that the country is moving in a great direction.
But he says real change needs to come from the protests.
No justice!
No peace!
I just hope that the country don't stop fighting.
He says one of the things his family feels strongly about that needs to change, they'd like to see more African-American law enforcement officers across the country. Reporting in Charlotte, Michelle Bowden, WCNC Charlotte.